Michael O'Donnell here with Purdue Extension. We are at Oak Ridge Farms in Pendleton, Indiana. That is just a little bit east, northeast of Indianapolis. It's May 14th, beautiful day for planting. John Paul Franks, who's owner-operator, the farmer here at Oak Ridge Farms, is out drilling soybeans today. This is a transitional field, so it's being transitioned to certified organic production. Last year, it was a prevent plant field. We had those super wet conditions in the spring of 2019 that prevented John Paul from being able to get in here and get a crop in 2019. So he managed weeds with some mowing, some disking, some fallow period. But then that gave the opportunity for him to set up with a really good cereal rye cover crop for 2020 transitional soybeans. He applied a ton and a half of poultry litter ahead of drilling the Elbon variety cereal rye at 150 pounds, so about 3 bushel. And that was drilled in early October. Could have gotten it in earlier, but got it in at a decent time with that good fertility, and we can see the result. This has headed out, good consistent stand. You know, the rye in this field varies from 4 foot to 5 or more feet tall. So we've got a lot of biomass that hopefully can provide that suppressive effect on the weeds throughout the full season. Also helps to moderate moisture by keeping that soil covered and moderate soil temperatures by keeping that soil covered. So ideally, John Paul would have come in here when the rye was at boot stage. We're obviously beyond boot stage. We can see that we're headed out. Soil conditions weren't right at boot, but he's dealing with what Mother Nature dealt him. Out today, drilling soybeans at about 200,000 seeds per acre, so pretty high seeding rate to account for less than ideal seed to soil contact with the drill, possibly some losses from the roller crimping, but really it's gonna help give him a good quick canopy since he's deciding to drill. He won't be coming in here with a high residue cultivator or anything, just getting those beans drilled, roller crimping the rye to terminate it. And those will be the operations to get this crop established. So again, ideally would have come in here when the rye was at boot stage instead of headed out. Couldn't do that, soil conditions weren't right. So he's gonna have to have some adaptive management. When we plant the beans at boot stage, we would then have about 30 to 45 days until full anthesis when that rye can be roller crimp terminated or mechanically terminated. And the timing when seeding the soybeans at boot stage until full anthesis, the beans would have been about V1, V2 growth stage where they're they're not vulnerable. They can withstand that roller crimping action and keep growing. With seeding the beans when the rye is headed out, John Paul is going to have to be a little more adaptive. Might consider coming in and rolling this rye down with his INJ roller crimper before the beans emerge. See if he can terminate some of it. Knowing that once the rye reaches anthesis, those beans might be in a vulnerable stage. So then he could possibly come in once those beans reach V1, V2, roller crimp again to try to get a more full or higher rate of termination on this rye. So gonna have to use some adaptive management in this no-till transitional soybean scenario. We can see John Paul running the drill there off towards the wood's edge into this standing cereal rye cover crop. Here's an area where he's already made some passes. We can see how this headed out rye gets knocked down, but a lot of it's gonna come back up where it's knocked down, and we can see even across other areas of the drill where it's still standing. This is where the tire tracks were. So obviously the tire track lays some of that rye down, but we're gonna see some of that come back up, except perhaps where the coulters of the drill slice some of that rye. So it's gonna be interesting to see how this field develops growing season with planting green into cereal rye cover crop for a no-till transitional soybean crop.